Hi, my name is Robert Raymond, and this is FamilySearch Full Text Search. It's even better. Let me point out a couple of stepping stones necessary along the way to the release of Full Text Search. The first is our computer-indexed obituaries. Human indexers are limited in what they can index per obituary. They were only indexing the most essential information. On the other hand, computer-aided indexing gathers a rich set of information. Computers do make mistakes. Rhett Butler and his wife, Scarlett O'Hare, are identified as the parents of Cammie King Conlon, the actress who played their on-screen daughter, Bonnie Blue Butler. We include a notice here to indicate the record was indexed by a computer. Then there's Chuck Berry's friend, Johnny B. Goode. Ooh, note this record was not indexed by a computer. Even people can make mistakes. Another stepping stone was character recognition of old newspapers. FamilySearch learned quickly that there were no commercial OCR software products that could read historical newsprint with sufficient accuracy to produce usable indexes. Commercial solutions are tuned to modern documents. This example illustrates some of the challenges. While it is readily readable by a person, commercial OCR struggles. So, FamilySearch built their own using artificial intelligence. And FamilySearch did it knowing the next step would be handwriting recognition. Here is a clipping with similar appearance to the last example, showing the FamilySearch transcription. With the exception of this creased text here, the transcription is nearly flawless. That brings us to RootsTech 2024, where FamilySearch released the full text search experiment. It looked almost identical to what it looks like today. But we've made a number of additions since RootsTech 2024. Since RootsTech, we have added hundreds of millions of images. This shows some of the larger groups of collections. Additionally, we're doing a joint project with the National Archives and Records Administration of the United States. They supplied 30,000 transcriptions for us to use to train our AI model. We then produced transcriptions, or extracted text, as they call it, for the remaining files. These are searchable in the NARA catalog. And by the time you watch this video, which I'm recording way back in November, they may be searchable on FamilySearch. To search on the NARA website, start at the series page in the catalog. I've provided a link to it in the handout. Click Search Within This Series. In this example, I searched for a soldier's name and where he lived when he applied for his pension. That's the kind of search you can't easily make otherwise. I got a record of his birth, service, and migrations after the war. Let's talk new features. This is the new landing page. Notice the name field. Actually, that's not new. The name field was present for RootsTech in 2024, although it made it only by about 3 days. And here is the place field and year range field, all of which we've added since RootsTech. And by the time you see this, we plan on an image group number search field. Below the search form, there used to be the list, a very short list, of the collections. That has been replaced with the collection title search box on the left. Start typing a word and a pop-up shows all matching collections. We've started producing collections automatically. You know, our average size for a full-text search collection is about 1/3 of a million records. Well, our goal for image publication in 2024 was 500 million images, 500 million. That means we had to create 1,300 collections. We can't do that. We can't manually keep up at that rate. We must automatically create collections. Alternatively, to searching for a collection, you can click on the Browse All Collections. Full text search then displays this list. Note that these are not the same collections as those in historical records. There's a separate list for full text search. Whether you select a collection from the main page or from the collection list, when you click it, FamilySearch brings you to a page that looks like this. Beyond transcriptions, we've added summaries and translations. Notice this is a Spanish language record. Click on Summarize to see a summary of the document in your own language, as long as your language is English, at least for the time being. I think the summaries are pretty good. Click here to show the document translated into your own language. Again, for the time being, that's English. I'm not as impressed with our translations as I am with our summaries, but they will improve. I still prefer copying the transcription to the clipboard and translating it with a chatbot. I ask the chatbot to show the translation like this. Now, I don't read or speak Spanish, so verifying the output of the AI, which you should always do, is a little hard for me, but when I have the chatbot produce the translation like this, I can verify the translation of these small snippets, and I can start to recognize words like testimony here. We have added a feature we call Fact View. Click this switch to toggle it on or off. In Fact View, instead of displaying text snippets with keyword matches, full text search displays the persons, places, and years the AI found in the image when it created the transcription. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you recognize the significance of this. FamilySearch Full Text Search is not your grandparents' full text search. Using AI, we not only have a transcription, we know which words are names, places, and dates. So are you tired of getting false hits searching for an ancestor named Hill or White? FamilySearch can limit results to just those it thinks are names. And it knows the difference between people and places. Searching for a place named after a person just got a whole lot easier. We've made it more convenient to access the citation. The pre-built citation was difficult to find. Now a button is available just above the image, and it's visible no matter which view you are in. Click it, and we pop up this pop-up window. We are working to improve the citations, but for now plan on reviewing and repairing it. For example, here is the citation as it appeared in November when I recorded this video. And here's the information it was missing. We're working on this, so it may have improved by the time you view this video. Utilize the Image Group Data tab to gather the missing information for your citation. and visit the catalog when necessary. FamilySearch improved the image download process. It used to be that these two icons had different functions. Now, when you click either one, Full Text Search displays this pop-up where you can download either a PDF or a JPEG. I want to give you some tips and tricks. When doing research of enslaved African Americans, it can help isolate records by including slavery-related keywords. Include one or two often used keywords to isolate results to enslaved people. You can see the list here in the top used keywords. As you go down the table, the keywords get inconsequential really, really fast. As you search, remember that a computer read the document and made many errors. Don't be afraid to use wildcards to make up for that. When you see odd characters, they actually mean something. Most of the time, they reflect the document contents. One character you'll often see is the keyboard character. This represents a symbol that the AI could not recognize. As of November 2024, these were the future possibilities. Some of these may be in place when you watch this video. First, more content. Our current AI models are tuned to English and Spanish, so we hope to deliver more content from English and Spanish speaking countries. The 2025 goal is to publish 1 billion images. Long term, the goal is to index all our mid-tier content. That may take several years. The question is under discussion, should we index everything? Our research team is working on models for 30 to 40 languages, with a long-term goal of having models for all languages at 95% accuracy. We have books and records in 159 languages. I told you about auto collections. In the future, we want to show more information about auto collections. This is an early visualization of what a collection page might look like. Here's something that should interest you. The product manager would like to allow users to sign up for notifications of additions to the collections. We expect these collections to grow over time as FamilySearch acquires new records. If we scroll down, we see that FamilySearch would really like to overcome the challenges of presenting coverage information for each collection. Here you can see a list of sublocalities up at the top, which tells you which places are included in the collection, and then you can infer which places are not. Here you see a list of record types, so you can see what's included in the collection. We're working on a smoother way to attach an image to the FamilySearch tree. Since we already know the names present in the record, we can present a list and allow you to select one or more of the names. You can correct the spelling of the name and add information about them from the record. You can attach the record to people already in the tree and add people not already in the tree. We'd like to provide improved filtering. One proposal is to move and combine the search criteria and the collection filters from the top and right sides of the windows. This is what it might look like to narrow results to one or more collections. And this is what it might look like to drill down into a place. And we need to figure out how to integrate full text search into the regular search experience. Do we combine different search experiences into one? Do we extend the already long search menu? Do we combine it with image search? We still need to work this out. That's all the time I have. Thank you for sticking with me to the end. I hope full text search provides you with many exciting discoveries. Thank you again.